Hey you! So today we're going to be reviewing the Ninja Super Steel Blaster, and I have to admit, I actually kind of really like the look of this. So I was really excited to actually pick this up. So let's have a look at the box. I love the fact that you've got the Red Ranger here. It comes with some darts. It comes with a, I'm guessing, rare super star that attaches here. It's obviously lights and sound, so we're going to be testing that one out. This spins, which I really like. It hones three darts, just like that. On the back, I really like the packaging for this one. So I like the fact that you've got the blade, the blaster there. You've got what it does, it fires, and then apparently this makes a sound. So I'm kind of interested to see what it says. It says like, rev up the spinner, launches darts up to 60 foot, and then obviously realistic battle sounds. So, wonder what they're gonna be. Down here, the other thing I actually really like is the ninja, this lion morpher. I think that's really cool. So you've got the ninja stars for the morpher for red, gold, and the lion morpher. You've got the three weapons. So the blade, the super blade, which is just premiered in a new episode, and obviously Levi's like kind of rocking guitar one. You've got some sort of battle armor. Then you've got these other really cool new things. So yeah, I was very kind of weirded out, or weirded, not weirded, but very kind of wondering what it is. So first of all, I'll let you guys have a look at this. Then obviously this. On the side, nothing. On the side there. And then just basically to get it right, we have that here. So on the bottom it says like Super Ninja Steel, and it says try me for sounds. Ninja Super Steel Blaster Launcher, Ninja Super Steel Blaster, Ninja Super Steel. So basically that's a lot of blasting for Super Ninja Steel. So let's actually like kind of take this out of the packaging, and yeah, just let's have a look. At first glance, it's not too bad for kind of a Nerf gun, but it also kind of really looks great. Now the one thing that is kind of I really wish they did on this was on this side is absolutely fine, but they could have painted this side. Obviously there's not really much paint, but again, like you've got the paint here, which is silver, but then on this side there's nothing. So it'd be kind of really nice if they made the, maybe the handle a little bit kind of chunkier, as well as having paint on both sides. Obviously you've got the kind of face, the lion, basically that's painted on both sides, so I'm kind of glad on that one. Otherwise it'd been a bit kind of meh, even for Bandai standards. So as I took out the sound, it also has on the bottom here, has a kind of switch to turn it on and off. So literally nothing on like that, but when you turn it on, actually makes a really good sound. So we're going to turn the sound off for a minute, but when you pull this down, this spins, which is really good. And then when you pop that, it actually kind of makes a popping sound. So let's try it with the sound. Oh, I thought it'd make some... thought it would make a generally different sound. So I like the fact it's just a one shot, like, and then, so there's a bit of a, it's a bit of a delay in this, which isn't really that bad, but I kind of really want to put the Nerf bullets in. So let's have a look at that. One of the other things you get is again the kind of ninja star, which I thought would be kind of like a lion blaster or something. So let's see what happens when you put it on. So it does open up a whole different sound, which I like. Definitely a different sound. So I'm hoping... that isn't actually too bad. I'm kind of liking that there's two different sounds on it. So again, let's put in the thing. I wonder, I really kind of wish I knew where the power star was, because I wonder if you put the Rangers one on there, would it be something different? But let's put in the kind of, the darts, basically. I've put in 3 darts, just like that. Let's see, but I haven't actually pushed them in. I'm wondering if it makes a click sound. Okay, so to put them in, it feels like you have to really either kind of push, but the top one goes in quite easily. So let's take back. So, okay, so rather than firing, I generally thought, maybe there is something in there, but they're actually just placeholders, so you can't really push any bullet sound, so you just get one, like that. So you kind of think that you'd fire, when you fired, like, you put one in there, so you all put them in, and then you could fire, like, 1, 2, 3, or you had to go 1, 2, 3. That to me would have been 10 times better. But to be fair, for the money that it cost at the moment of the time of recording this video, this was from the Entertainer for around about £33. And I've got to admit, like, having just as a blaster, like, if you're using this for special effects, this is actually a quite nice way of doing it. Obviously, using a blaster if you want to, like, shoot someone, or if you want to have a nerf battle. You'd be very kind of underpowered though, because by the time they've shot you like 20 times, you've probably shot them once. But this seems to be like, you could do it maybe like a sniper rifle, just like that, get your enemy, and then shoot it down. But to be honest, I generally thought I'd be very kind of like, oh, I've wasted my money. But to be honest, I generally really like this. I just really like the whole click action, and then just, so maybe they could have given something slightly different. Like, you could maybe put these in, so you basically fire one per one. So hopefully when Hasbro, they turn around and go, yeah, we're gonna make proper Nerf guns, something like this will come along a bit more. Oh yeah, it's like, where am I gonna put these? So I'm very kind of like okay with it. But generally, I think you could have had a bit more. So if we shoot it, I don't want it to shoot anywhere in the room. But if you fire it like that way, I've got to admit, it bounces really, really well. Like, I don't even know where that one went. But it generally is a whole easy enough to kind of shoot. You just kind of think that either you have to be a quick shot to actually get off the firepower. But if you and your friends had a few of these and you just basically went around and shot people with it, within reason, if you're playing a game against your friends, not just randomly shooting people in the street, I generally think that this would be actually really worth it. For the kind of toys that the Super Ninja Steel line has had, or pretty much are going to release, this one, as well as the Lion Morpher, are possibly two of my favorites from the entire line. And probably, if you're not counting like Legacy line, but you're counting lines where this came out normally, I would definitely say that this is possibly one of my favorite mainstream Power Ranger toys to date. I generally just think it's the whole, it's not just like a click click, it's a proper shotgun sound, like, oh, I love it. So I think that if you kept doing that and then shooting it, you'd get more kind of power from it. But it says it can shoot up to 60 foot or feet. And the instructions, battery, spin together, sound, release. You can take the star off, sound enhance. I generally thought there'd be a little bit more, but for what you get for your money, obviously you know that if these don't sell well, they will reduce in price. And if they do, I think I might pick up a few more. So there we go, Rangers. There is the Super Ninja Steel Blaster. What are your thoughts on this? Is this something that you would pick up? Are you gonna kind of give it a miss. Let me know down below in the comments. If you like this video, like, favorite, comment, and consider subscribing. Check out all the other videos on the channel. If you want to help out the channel on Patreon, link is in the description down below. And as always, Rangers, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in a bit.